different had different numbers, but you had a problem on it that said find the rectangular coordinates for something. In this case, it's 6, 30. Now, 6, 30, and we're finding the rectangular coordinates. Which means, what are we looking for? If we're looking for rectangular coordinates, we're looking for
x and y.
X and y. And we have formulas that say x equals r cosine theta and y equals r sine theta. And this is r and this is theta. Those are polar coordinates, r and theta. So, x equals 6 cosine 30 and y equals 6 sine 30. Now, on your quest, you will have a calculator. So you can just type in 6 cosine 30, 6 sine 30, and that will be your ordered pair, whatever those numbers are. On this quiz, you didn't have a calculator because the angle is 30 degrees. And you are supposed to know how to find the sine and cosine of 30 degrees, or 45 or 60. So across from the 30 is 1, across from the 60 is root 3, and the hypotenuse is 2. All right, if you take any future math class, that's going to be something you're expected to know. That's one of those kind of just main things that you're supposed to know, the special triangles. Now, for x, we want the cosine. Cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. So we have 6 times root 3 over 2, which is, for those of you that have a hard time multiplying, remember, you go straight across. So that's 6 root 3 over 2, which makes it 3 root 3. Cancels, 3 root 3. And then the sine of 30 is 1/2. So that's 6 times 1/2, which is 3. So for that quiz and those numbers, there are the answers. Okay? Your quiz probably had a different angle. Maybe you had a 60 or a 45, but you do exactly the same thing. Your picture's just set up a little bit differently. All right, anybody else have a question about one of those quiz questions, Max?
Where is -4, 10 degrees plotted?
-4, 10 degrees, where is it plotted? Because obviously, you can't plot on your quest. I'm going to give you some points, and you're going to have to plot them on one of those circular grids. If I gave you this point, you can't plot it because that says get on the circle that has a negative radius. Well, that doesn't even make sense. So we make that a +4, but when we do that, we have to go halfway around the circle. We go to the opposite side of the circle. So instead of being at 10 degrees, we're going to go around halfway, which would put us at 190. Because half a circle is 180 degrees. And we want to go halfway around. Now, the question always comes up, should I add 180 or subtract 180? Well, if 180 is halfway around the circle, if you added or if you subtracted, wouldn't you end up at the same spot? So the answer is governed by whatever you put here. Remember, we talked about this yesterday. Do I want to have an angle bigger than 360?
No.
No. So if adding 180 makes the number too big, then don't add 180, subtract 180. In this case, I would not subtract 180 because what happens if I do 10 minus 180? I get a negative number, and I don't want a negative angle. So you're going to either add or subtract depending on which one gives you an acceptable answer. And an acceptable answer is one that's between 0 and 360. You don't want to be bigger than 360, and you don't want to be negative. So if the original angle had been 200, then I would not add 180, because what happens if I add 180? Is bigger than 360. So in that case, I would subtract 180. You can do either one. You just do the one that makes the answer the way it needs to be. Got it?
Got it.
All right, anything else from the quiz? Nothing? We're good? All right, practice quiz number one. Here we go, big day. Exciting. So in that packet, practice quest or pre-quest, pre-quest number one. Now, some of us worked through this yesterday in Flex. Jake, I'm going to put you on the spot.
Come on, Jake.
When I look at page one of my practice quest number one, there are four problems. Jake, do you remember about these? What's special about these four problems?
Yes, because
one and four.
Oh.
Exactly. All right, so here's what I want you to do. I want you to look at this front page, which is structured exactly like the quest you're going to take right after spring break. All right? It is structured exactly the same. I want you to look at question number one and question number four. One and four. Notice that one and four both start with an R and a theta and ask you to find an X and a Y. So, 3162 needs to be converted to an X and a Y. When it says convert to rectangular means X, Y. Well, we just did this on our quiz. What does X always equal? R cosine theta, and Y equals R sine theta. Now, you have a calculator to do this. You can't do this angle without a calculator. So you're just gonna type in 3 cosine 162, and there are no directions on here, so let's round to the 100. So negative 2.85, and then 3 sine 162 is 0.93. There's the answer to the question. That, yeah, Pop says, wow, that's easy. That's incredibly easy. If you remember what you're supposed to be doing, which is finding X and Y. Now, go down to number four. And I would recommend on test day, that's what you do. You do number one, then jump down to number four. Because number four is exactly the same. Convert to rectangular. That means I need X and Y. And what is X always equal to? R cosine theta. So in this case, it's 5 cosine 100 and 5 sine 100. Remember in your CIS notation, this is R, this is theta. I mean, obviously that's theta, it's got a degree mark on it. So I go to my calculator, 5 cosine 100, and 5 sine 100. Now, some of you are gonna write this as an ordered pair, like you did this one, and I'll take off some points, not full credit, but I'll take off some credit, because the problem is not an ordered pair. The problem has an I in it. So this answer is written with an I, X plus YI. You find your X and your Y in exactly the same way. If the problem is an ordered pair, the answer, if the problem's an ordered pair, the answer is an ordered pair. if the problem has an I in it, then the answer has an I in it. And the I always goes with the what, why. Okay, so that takes care of 1 and 4. Now, 2 and 3 are different. I mean, 2 and 3 are like each other, but they're different from this. Problem 2 says find polar. That means I have given you X and Y, and you have to find R and theta. And we do that by drawing a picture. Over 3, down 4. This will be R, right here, that's R. And this will be theta. Okay, how do we find R?
Pythagorean
theorem. Just like finding magnitude. Square, square, add them up and take the square root. So it looks like my R value is 5. Pythagorean theorem. 3 squared plus 4 squared. Now, the pink angle is the one I want, but I can't find it. I'm going to have to find this angle right here. Okay, you with me? And how do I find that angle? Second tangent 4/3. Second tangent opposite over adjacent. That's going to find this angle right here. Second tangent 4/3. So I'll find that. Second tangent 4/3. 53.13. Do not put 53.13 as the answer. The answer is the pink. So we got to subtract that angle from 360. That's exactly right. So your theta is 306.87. All the way around is 360. That pink thing is going all the way around except for 53. That's why we subtract it. What? Pythagorean theorem. 3 squared plus 4 squared equals r squared. Now, the next one, notice the directions are the same, at least in the beginning. Convert to polar. That means you need to find r and theta. So we got 2 plus 3i, and we're going to find an r and a theta. Okay, so this is an x and a y. So I'm going to draw over 2, up 3. This is my r, Pythagorean theorem, that would be my r. So that would be the square root of 13. Now, because I'm in quadrant 1, this is theta. That angle is theta. The one I find is the one I get to use. And how do I find it?
Second
tangent 3 over 2. It's always y over x, opposite over adjacent. Opposite over adjacent. So second tangent 3/2 is 56.31. And that is my theta, because it's in quadrant 1. Now, if you write your answer as an ordered pair, like you did over here, I'm going to count it partly wrong, because the question was not an ordered pair. The question had an I in it. So I have to put my CIS in the middle of that R and theta. If your problem is x comma y, then your answer will be r comma theta. if your problem is X plus YI, then your answer will be R CIS theta. Same R, same theta, same mathematics, just a different way of writing your answer. Okay, page one, done. Let's look at page two. Convert to a polar equation. Now, this is the one that if anyone misses it, you deserve to be, I don't know what. Not executed, but certainly, I don't know. Something. Why? Because this, there's no thought involved in this problem. What does X always equal?
R cosine theta.
Kids, I've used that now 3 times in 5 problems. So I would think that would be something you would want to have memorized. X equals R cosine theta. So when I see this X right here, 2 R cosine theta. Plus, what's Y? R sine theta. Done. Mission accomplished, problem finished. Take out the X, replace it with what X always equals, which is R cosine theta. Take out the Y, replace it with what Y always equals, R sine theta, and you are finished. Don't miss that.
That's so easy.
That is so easy. Now, the next one, when we did them in our notes, you thought they were easy, but they're definitely more complicated than this. Does anybody remember how we changed this into a rectangular equation? Remember where we start? I'll give you a hint. Right here is where you start. What do we do with that? There's kind of my little setup showing an X and a Y, an R and a theta. Tell me about sine theta. What's the sine of theta? Look at the picture. What's the sine of theta?
Y over R.
Y over R. So I'm going to take out sine theta and I'm going to replace it with Y over R. Now, next time you see this problem, that might not be a sine. It doesn't or shouldn't matter what it is. You're supposed to know what your trig functions are. Sine is opposite over hypotenuse. Tangent is opposite over adjacent. Whatever the function is, you're going to think about that triangle right there. You might even draw it at the top of your paper, and you're going to substitute in. Now, who remembers the next step?
Multiply
out the R. Or multiply out whatever is in the denominator. Depending on the function, it may or may not be an R. But whatever the denominator is, multiply both sides by it. Then what? One more step. Who remembers? No. Take a look up here. Isn't it true that x squared plus y squared is r squared?
Yeah.
So what am I going to do with that r squared? No, I'm not going to square root it.
Change it into x squared.
Change it into x squared plus y squared. Kids, I'm not saying you couldn't square root it, but your job is to write an equation that has x's and y's. If you square root it, you're still going to have an r. No r's. We want just x's and y's. When it says write as a rectangular equation, we want just x's and y's.
So how can we change r squared into x squared plus y squared?
Isn't that the beggar in here? Yeah. All right, number 7. This we just learned yesterday. Let's see if we can remember it. We are going to multiply and divide these two numbers. So we have 6 CIS 100 and 8 CIS 150, and we are going to multiply them and divide them. multiply. Who remembers the rule for multiplying these guys?
You multiply the first one, then the second.
Multiply these numbers, because these would be ours, so that would be 48. And then we put our CIS, and then what do we do with these guys?
Add them.
Add them, so that would be 250. And then, we gotta be careful, cause sometimes our alarm bells go off, but not this time, cause 250 is fine, right? That angle's fine. So that's the answer. Done.
Oh, yeah.
We should not miss this question either. It's easy. Got another rules. We multiply the Rs and add the angles. Right? Let's stay focused. Now, what about the division? How do we do the division? You divide these and subtract that. Now, when you do the division, you need to reduce. So you get 6/8, which is 3/4. Now, you will have a calculator. So if you put 0.75, that's fine. But you have to reduce it. Don't put 6/8. Then we subtract. Uh-oh, this is where we're going to have a problem. Because what happens when I subtract? I get negative 50. And while that would get you partial credit, to get full credit, you have to fix that angle. What do we do to fix that angle?
360.
Add 360. Remember, if you get an answer that is too big, if it's more than 360, you subtract 360. If you get an answer that's too small, that's negative. It needs to be bigger than zero. If it's too small, you add 360. So if I add 360 to that, my final answer for the division problem will be that. Agreed? Alright. Now number 8. This is one, we did a few of these yesterday. This was the last thing we did. Okay, so we need to raise this number to the 5th power, and we're going to answer in polar form, which means our answer is going to look like this. CIS is polar form. Okay? This is called polar form. So we're going to answer in polar form, which is actually good, because that's what's going to come out. All right, who remembers step one? Well, that's an X and a Y, guys. X is negative root 3 and Y is 1. If I'm going to be in polar form, I need an R and a theta. Right? So, take a look at that. That should sort of look familiar to you. That triangle. What's the hypotenuse?
Oh,
2. 2. What's the angle that's right here across from the 30? Oh, across from the 1 is a 30. Now, you're going to have a calculator. So if that doesn't make sense to you, if you're like, what? Do the Pythagorean theorem. That's how we get 2. And then do second tangent, 1/√3. That's how you can get 30. All right, so my number is 2 CIS, watch it, not 30, you're not in quadrant 1. Remember, if your picture is not drawn in quadrant 1, you will need to make an adjustment. Okay, something will be negative, and you need to make an adjustment. So, if I went all the way to here, that would be 180, right? Am I going that far?
No.
No. I'm stopping 30 degrees before 180, which means that angle must be 150. Whoa, we're not done. We still have to raise it to the 5th power. We haven't done that part yet. Whoa, that's going to be huge. Don't make that mistake on test day. you need to get it in polar form, but then you need to raise it to the fifth power. So Jake, what did you say?
You've got to take 2 to the fifth power and 150 times 5.
Exactly. Jake's all over it. We got to take 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 5 times. So 2 to the fifth, I get 32. And then I need to do 150 plus 150 plus 150 plus 150 5 times. So that'll be 750. Whoops! Too big. So I got to take out actually 2 360s. So that goes all the way down to 30. And there is the answer to the question. Alright, so make a little star by that, people, so you don't forget that part. Okay, well, it just accidentally came out to be 30. It won't usually do that. It just did this time. All right, now number 9. Plot the following points. Be sure to label them A and B. Remember, the test, the quest, looks exactly like this. So the directions are going to say, plot the following points. Be sure to label them A and B. So do what the directions say. Here we go. First point. What about that first point? It is a radian measure, so we're going to want to change 3, 2π/3. We're going to change that into degrees. Since our graph paper is in degrees, did you notice that? Your graph paper's in degrees. So you're going to want to label or change your radian measure into a degree measure. So pi is 180. Divided by 3 is 60. Times 2 is 120. So to plot point A, we're going to find a 120 degree line, and it is labeled for you 120 degrees right there. So you get on that line and count out from the center 1, 2, 3. So there is point A, and mark it point A. On the 120 line, 3 circles out from the center. So start at the center and count out 1, 2, 3. Boom. Now, -4, 60. We have talked about this earlier. Do not get on the 60 line. That will be wrong.
4, 2, 40.
This is going to be 4, 2, 40. Because when the radius is negative, you have to change the angle 180 degrees. So we'll get on our 240 line, which again is labeled for you. You start at the center and count out 1, 2, 3, 4, and there is point B. Now, it is unfortunate that we have spring break in the middle of all this, but honestly, folks, this is such easy stuff. If we have to break something up, this is the unit to do it, because this is easy. You have to do a little review, but this is easy. All right, last one, last question. We're gonna sketch this. Now, I am not asking you to sketch it by hand. You have a graphing calculator. You're gonna type in, wait a minute. I've loaned my calculator out. If I wanna graph 5 sine 2 theta, if I want to graph that, I need to be in what mode? Probably degrees because my graph paper, but I need to be in polar. So I don't know who's used your calculator or how it's set up, but you need to be in polar mode if you're not. because that's the only way you're gonna be able to type in this equation. This is a polar equation. So I am set in degrees and I am set in polar, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and type in my equation, 5 sine 2 theta. And remember, theta is your variable button, your X button. And I'm gonna hit graph and see what happens. Now, one of two things is gonna happen. You're gonna get a picture, or you're not. And I'm not. So that means there's something wrong with my window. So I'm gonna go to my window. I am in degree mode. So what should my theta, min, and max be if I'm in degree mode? 0 to 360. And I told you the day we graphed that if you're gonna be in degree mode, what should your theta step be? No, not 0.1, not if you're in degrees, it needs to be 5. If it's not 5, you're going to take forever. Use 0.1, it'll graph, but it'll take a long, long time. So 5 is fine. For X and Y, I would just use a regular standard window, negative 10 to 10. If you're thinking ahead, you know how long these leaves are. So I don't really need negative 10 to 10 because these leaves are only 5, but the problem you're graphing will be different. So I'll just hit graph. And then I'm going to, as carefully as possible, reproduce that graph on my grid.
What's the theta min?
0. Remember, I am not going to give you information on the test. You're going to have to figure it out yourself. So the idea is that you are familiar enough with what the shapes are supposed to look like that you will be able to adjust your window to fit. This is what we get, a 4-leaf rose. How did I know that those leaves are going to clear out to the fifth circle?
Because it tells you.
It tells you in the problem. It tells you in the problem they go out to the fifth circle.
I did not expect that at all.
So this tells me I have 4 leaves, right?
Yeah.
And this tells me they're 5 units long. So you don't necessarily need to remember that, but you need to graph it accurately because I will take points off if these leaves aren't long enough. If you graph them shorter, I'll take points off because they're not shorter. They're 5 units long. In this problem, they might be shorter in another problem. Okay? I said 0. But again, Shelley, you need to work on figuring that out yourself, okay? Now, it makes sense that if I'm in degrees, I'm gonna go from 0 to 360, one time around the circle. That makes sense. All right. That is done. Now, what we're gonna do is we're not gonna start the second one. We're gonna do that one tomorrow. Actually, did I give you 3?
Second one, though.
Did I give you 3?
You did, yeah.
Okay, that's good. Because we'll do one tomorrow, and I'll leave one for you to do over break, but I'll videotape it. Because you didn't grab the right equation. I don't know what equation you had. You're supposed to be graphing 5 cosine 2 theta. Oh, I did cosine. Yeah, I did sine. Okay, now what we're going to do.
No, it's just power.
Let's see if I got power.
Front page of this packet, there is some more practice. Actually, there's a little bit more on the back too. Let's do this just to get a little more practice. Tomorrow we will do practice test two. I will videotape practice test three and post it for you to do over break on your own.
Hey.
And then we will take the quest. Our first day back, whatever day I have, we have class, we have a quest.
That's a
true tax.
Yep.
Why are you doing that?
I'm not.
It's just a tax.
All right. Here we go. I do care about you very much. That's why I'm going to videotape another review for you to look at.
Spring break.
All right. Number one, convert to polar coordinates. Convert to polar coordinates. What does that mean I'm looking for? I'm on the very front page of our packet. I'm looking for R and beta. That's exactly right. So I have been given an X and a Y. And I need to figure out an R and, to be careful, beta. All right, so what's my R? Got to do the Pythagorean theorem. So 25 plus 9, 34. Now theta. This is not a special triangle, like a 30, 60 or something. So I'm going to need my calculator. What buttons do I press?
Second tangent,
5/3. That's how we find the angle. Sometimes we can tell what it is. Usually we can't. So when we can't, we have to use our calculator. Second tangent, 5/3. And I got 59.04. Now, when will the answer on the calculator actually be the number I use? If I'm in quadrant one. If I'm not in quadrant one, then I have to figure out my angle. So I'm looking at this situation. All the way to here would be 180, but I'm not going that far. So I'm going to do 180 minus 59.
Yeah.
And 120.96 is my angle. Now, sometimes I write my answer as an ordered pair, and sometimes I write it with the CIS. Which way is the right way for this problem?
Ordered pair.
Why? Because the original problem was an ordered pair. When the original problem is an ordered pair, the answer is an ordered pair. Okay. Next. Number two, convert to rectangular coordinates. What does that mean?
Easy.
These are the easy ones, because that means I'm looking for X and Y, right?
Yeah.
Rectangular means X and Y. So X equals 7 cosine 135. And y equals 7 sine 135.
Oh, my Lord.
Right? So you're going to have a calculator for this thing. So even though 135 is special, we're going to go ahead and use our calculator. So I got negative 4.95 and positive 4.95. Is it appropriate to write that as an ordered pair this time? Yes, because that's how the problem started. So if you start with an ordered pair, you're going to end with an ordered pair every time. If you start with R theta, you're going to end with XY. If you start with XY, you're going to end with R theta. Write as a polar equation. This is the embarrassing one. You're going to write this as a polar equation.
Oh, yeah.
What's X?
R
cosine theta.
R
sine theta. Yeah, you're taking out the X and the Y. Remember, X is R cosine theta, and Y is R sine theta. Just plug it in. Number four, convert to rectangular form. Now, what have you been given here? What is this and this? What is that?
X and Y.
That's not X and Y. That is R and theta. So you need to find X and Y, right?
We need to draw.
Actually, we don't need a picture. How do we find X? X equals R cosine theta and Y equals R sine theta. If you are trying to find X and Y, use your formulas. Yeah, you could draw a picture, but that makes it so much harder. So 5 cosine 97 is negative 0.61, and 5 sine 97 is 4.96. Now, you got to decide what you're going to do with these. Are you going to write them as an ordered pair?
No.
You're not. You've got the right numbers, but there was an I in the problem. So you're going to write negative 0.61 plus 4.96i. It's always x plus yi. The I always goes with the y. I think we already did problem 5, but let's do it again. Where do we plot that? At 4, 190. Remember, if R is negative, we add 180 or subtract 180 from the angle. What's a lemniscate look like? A figure 8. So any kind of figure 8 you draw for 6 would be good. Number 7, convert to polar form.
We have a question.
Yep. There isn't such a thing as a two-leaf rose. Yeah. Remember, Janae, that isn't a stupid question. Actually, that's a good question. Remember, in the equation of a rose, it looks something like this, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And in order, the number of leaves comes from this number.
Yeah.
If that number is odd, it will be that number, right? Exactly. So there's no way to get to a two-leaf rose. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
Because if you put a 2 there, there'd be 4. But if you put a 1 there, there'd only be 1. Yeah. So there's no way to get a 2.
Okay.
All right. So now, last one on this page. We're going to hurry. We'll get this done, and then we'll call it quits, I think.
Yep.
We're going to convert to polar form. So here we go. Convert to polar form. So, if we're converting to polar, that means we are looking for R and theta, correct? Which means we must have been given an X and Y. So, R will be the square root of 29 by the Pythagorean theorem. And theta this time will be all the way around to here. That's theta. So I gotta figure out this guy first, this angle right here. How do I find angles? Second tangent. And this one will be 5 over 2, opposite over adjacent, y over x. So second tangent, 5 over 2, is 68.2. Now, when do I use the number on my calculator as my theta? If I'm in quadrant 1. I am not in quadrant 1, so please don't write 68.2 down. Adjust it. You are going all the way to here, which is 180, and then you're going 68.2 more. So your answer is going to be 68.2 plus 180, which is 248.2. Now that's your R and that's your theta. Are you going to write it as an ordered pair? No, because this was an ordered pair. So it's going to be CIS. Our answer is root 29 CIS 248.2. Janae, is your hand up?
No.
All right, so that takes care of that. So tomorrow, maybe we'll have time to do that very last practice quiz back here.
Yeah, definitely.
I want to give you...
Don't make her a video.